जिस दिन आकाश पैदा होगा, चेहरा चांद का साफ होगा, जिस दिन समय ने आंखें खोली, इंसाफ 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 होगा।
Gulzar Saab and Meghna, a very big welcome to our show.
Thank you.
Your film opened really well at Toronto Film Festival. Huge applause. Did you expect that kind of reaction? Tell us what happened there.
When you know that your film, which was not exactly made for a foreign audience,
right,
it was made for our people in India, but it just so happened that it got that platform to premiere on,
right,
TIFF. And then your first screening is in a hall of 1,300 people,
wow,
65-70% of which are non-Indian. And from the first quip of dialogue,
right,
that happens in the film, you have those 1,300 people engaged,
mm-hmm,
and they all laugh together,
wow,
they cringe together. It was an unforgettable moment. I wish he was there to see it.
Mm.
Really.
Even I wish so.
Yeah,
I wish I was there. But it's very heartening,
yeah,
and very satisfying to hear this from,
right,
her.
Yeah. Gulzar Saab, what was your first reaction when you heard that Meghna is making a film on this subject?
Film banane se pehle bhi, there is a process of picking up a subject.
Right.
And I could see that process happening when she was, the way she was, but she was reading like all of us in the newspaper.
Yeah.
In the media.
Just what was being reported.
Yeah, television pe bhi aa raha tha, us pe bhi aa raha tha, aate aate. When I saw her collecting some of these cuttings, and I thought, she's studying it or what it is. So all that I did was that मेरे सामने कोई cuttings आ जाते थे निकाल paper में आ जाते थे cutting निकाल के भेजना शुरू कर दिया बच्चों को. So this was my reaction, but I appreciated it. It was daring to do a thing like this.
आपने ये कहा है कि you probably wouldn't have been able to make a film on a subject like this.
In our times, perhaps it was difficult.
Right, it was difficult.
It was difficult. मतलब इवन माचिस बनाते हुए भी हमें इतने खौफ थे और कितना करेंगे, कितना सेंसर होगा. रियलिटी को एज रियल करके पेश करना इन अ मीडियम ऑफ फिक्शन
इज डिफिकल्ट. या
उसकी खूबसूरती ये है और उसका कमाल भी यही है. आई कुड सी दैट ऑन द पेपर व्हेन विशाल सेंड मी द स्क्रिप्ट. हालांकि मुझे एक दफ़ा व्यूज टू माय ओल्ड सिनेमा मैंने उसमें सवाल भी पूछा था. शी टोल्ड मी कि शी हैज़ केप्ट दैट
Really?
जो मैंने रिमार्क्स दिए थे. और शी कैन एक्सप्लेन इट टू यू.
टेल मी अबाउट दैट. या या
हिज कमेंट ऑन द फर्स्ट ड्राफ्ट वाज कि इट्स टू मच इन्वेस्टिगेशन, इट्स टू क्लिनिकल, वेयर इज द इमोशन.
रियली?
या एंड
उसके बाद इन्होंने नहीं दिखाई मुझे.
इज दैट ट्रू मेघना?
या बिकॉज़ यू नो द थिंग वाज विशाल जी एंड आई वर वेरी क्लियर दैट वी डिडंट वांट टू एक्सप्लॉइट द इमोशंस बिहाइंड दिस पीस. दैट वाज नॉट द आईडिया एट ऑल. What we wanted to do was actually investigate the investigations.
Correct, correct, yeah.
And when he said, where is the emotion, we actually had a very secret high five ki, you know, we succeeded.
Yeah.
You know, there is no emotion in the film.
No emotion.
So, yeah, and then we decided we're not going to share any of the other 9 drafts
with
of,
him.
Of the script.
Yeah.
And then we showed him the film when it was like more
ready.
Or less our cut was ready.
Mm-hmm.
But I do appreciate that this present day cinema is ahead of my times.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, that's what you have to appreciate.
Correct,
if you are...
Yeah.
Looking at it objectively, with every film of Vishal,
correct.
I feel very nice about it. He's doing things. He's going ahead with it.
In fact, Gulzar Saab, you have said that today's cinema reflects society more than what it did, you know, in the past.
In the past, it was more of a storytelling.
Right.
And within the storytelling, you had to punch in your own times.
Right.
The politics
message
of its time or the social values of its times and. You had to punch in within a storytelling.
Right.
Now it's just the times you straight away narrate it and it's a story by itself.
Right.
The audience has also matured to take it.
Yeah, absolutely.
And the makers have matured more.
To make such
this little girl has become such a big director. I'm happy. They're going ahead of me.
Meghna, you've always been ahead of your times. You made a movie like Filal on Surrogacy, which is like so many years ago.
Mm.
Would you wish it released sometime now? Would you have seen the film differently then?
I am sure that if I had made Filhal today, it would look like a very different film. It would probably have the same people because I can't think of anybody better than Tabu and Sushmita
Absolutely.
To play those roles. But I would have probably treated it very differently.
Right. Do you also see the range that Meghna has gone through from her earlier films to now?
Yes, I do.
Yeah?
I do. When Filhal came, I think it was again ahead of its
absolutely,
time.
Absolutely, absolutely.
हाँ उस दौर में किसी ने उस तरह की फिल्म नहीं बनाई थी and बल्कि कुछ लोग जो उसमें शामिल थे जो who didn't believe in it in their real life it happened to them the same right. thing. तो वो भी बहुत दिलचस्प बात है लेकिन when she made Filhal I wouldn't have thought of that subject.
Right.
It's totally only a lady, only a woman can right. think of that subject.
Right.
I wouldn't have thought of it. हालांकि I remember उन्होंने एक बात कही थी कि जो अगर होता नहीं उस जमाने में कि आपके यहाँ अगर फर के औलाद चाहिए या लड़का नहीं होता तो then either keep a prostitute or keep on another या दूसरी शादी कर लो. This was no solution. This was not a, it's all fiction.
Right.
And she made a reality based film in Filhal.
Tell me, Meghna, as we were researching this film, we went deep into the subject. It was an intrigue value, right? It was very dark, it was scary. You as a mother, as a daughter, how do you react to it? And how did you stay objective? Because there were so many ways of looking at the same thing.
Because you had to forget that you're a daughter and a mother. For me, I think throughout the making of this film, even up to editing it,
really,
I had to forget that this was a real incident. That it was just a screenplay, that these were just characters, and I had to be completely mechanical about it. You know, it would hit me at very, very unpredictable times. Like, I mean, we were wrecking for locations for the film, and to get the right references, we went to all the actual locations.
Oh, wow.
And we were standing outside the prison. And that is when it hit me like a rock, right, you know, that, you know what? These are not characters.
Actually
they're real
happened.
People and they are across that wall in a cell somewhere. So it would come and hit me at the most unpredictable times, but it was very important to, you know, be completely clinical and forget emotion, reality, all of that. Otherwise the film would reflect that slant.
Right, right. Well, that's how, did you, were you very protective when Meghna became a filmmaker?
Contrary, I felt proud of it.
Very
that
proud
she, she's made a choice, her own choice.
Yeah.
She could become an actress also. She,
right.
Her mother was a famous
right.
star and actress. She could have chosen anything.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I did. I was very liberal about her choice of whatever she wants to do.
Mm-hmm.
I made her, in her childhood also, made her do the paintings also and go for dances also and learn karate also and ballet also. So that tomorrow if you have to choose a career,
right.
you should not be afraid of it.
It was not about being protective.
Yeah.
When I assisted him, I didn't ever assist him on the shooting process.
Okay.
Because when I was on set, he would get distracted.
While he was directing.
I'm bored to nahi ho rahi, kahan baithi hu, kya kar rahi hu. He would get distracted
right.
because he could not disconnect being a father, even when he was making the film.
Mm-hmm.
So I decided that I will not assist him on set.
Right.
I assisted him in post.
Okay.
I assisted him while the script was being worked on.
Mm.
For the on-set part, I went to Saeed Mirza Saab.
Okay.
Because I knew I'd be able to also learn more. Also,
right.
you know, when your father is the director of the film, then it becomes baby ke liye kursi lao, baby ke liye juice lao, toh kaam karne ka mauka
nahi. So you want to stay away from his range of vision.
I don't want to be pampered on the set.
Correct.
If I'm going as an assistant, I need to work
right.
and learn.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, you know, so that was actually how it played out.
Yeah.
And I couldn't cease to be a father.
Right.
How could I?
Yeah.
Hana? Yeah. Hota rahega.
Correct.
But he was like a very like a pampering father. So I'm sure you know he never shouted at you for anything.
I'm
like
the
marks,
best
right?
at spoiling children.
Yeah. Then would
no,
you
nobody
know,
can spoil children better than me.
Really?
But where education was concerned,
he was strict.
Not strict, but he was very clear that this is something you cannot take lightly.
Mm-hmm.
Education and if my piano and all those
right,
other classes that I was doing, you can't faff around with that. That has to be done. Not because you need to be good at it or whatever, you need to give it that respect that it deserves.
Yeah. You know, you've done so well for yourself, Meghna. You've made such nice movies, you write so beautifully. But has his writing had a very strong influence on you? Is the benchmark always so high?
It's
so,
not a benchmark.
No?
I don't look at it like that because, frankly, I don't consider it even possible. You know?
It's so, another way of looking at it.
Yeah, I don't consider it a possibility. Fluke se agar ho gaya, by the way, toh theek hai, but that is not, that's not my finishing line.
Fluke se ho gaya,
but I know that his creativity has subconsciously affected me.
Do you always give her a lot of feedback on her writing, on her filmmaking, even in this movie?
No, I didn't get much chance.
You didn't get much chance, she was so good.
And for her scripts, naturally, no.
Really?
She writes her own script.
Yeah.
That's what she kept going from the first film. And for her documentary and everything. It's now that she's with another writer, with Vishal. And they make a good team.
Yeah.
I think they complement each other very well.
Yeah.
And I think that has gone very well.
Yeah.
But otherwise, she had been writing her own script all day long. Yeah. And Filhal was a very tricky thing to write.
Absolutely.
And then she wrote another film, Just Married.
Just Married, yeah.
Ooh. That was another very interesting film. Though, halanki I always tell her ke wo light-hearted banaya tumne, lekin, but it was a good film.
Gulzar sahab, we believe you still spend 7 hours a day working. Is that true?
It's a discipline of a writer.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I do that. I'm a clerk of my own, sir. I mean, by 10:30, 11, I'm on my table and work till about 5 o'clock.
Yeah.
After that, it's my grandson. It's his time.
But does he keep up with technology?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, with your mobiles and your iPads
and
all that?
And I keep learning from
that. Do you keep up? But do you have an interest in that?
Not only from her.
Yeah.
Even from my grandson.
Oh, really?
He tells me something which he does, I don't know, which when I can't switch it on, suddenly he plays it. See your photo.
Will you direct a film again?
No.
No.
The reason is film takes away all the time. It's a 24-hour job.
Right.
It's something that you can't, then you can't do other things.
Yeah.
So I had to draw a line somewhere.
Hmm.
And because I had about 100 books in my head, or so many books in my head, which I wanted to. Then working for children, particularly writing for children. Yeah. In India, there's a lot of need to do that. Because otherwise, we have been only translating books coming from West, but except Marathi, Bangla, and Malayalam. Except these three languages, there's no children's work done here in literature, in Indian literature.
Meena, during the process of making Talwar, at any point, did you feel this urge to go and meet them?
Go and meet them?
Yeah, because we're so deep into the case, right? So,
yes, there was an urge, I will not deny it.
Right.
Because you really want to see the human beings who have gone
Absolutely.
Through this
yeah.
and what they are like and what how they are processing it. But I had to fight that, and I was very clear that I wouldn't, because like I said, if I have to keep my objectivity intact and I have to keep my own opinions and biases out of the realm of making this film, I don't want to do anything that will color me or affect the neutrality of the film.
One question I want to ask both of you. You'll work together as creative people. He writes lyrics for your movies. Is there a disagreement, like creative disagreement ever? Meghna's already smiling. She's looking at you.
It's a thought disagreement.
Okay.
Thought-wise, we may agree on a thing or not, but it's not called a creative difference.
But he complains that I make him rewrite the songs very often.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And you do that?
She makes me do it twice and thrice and times. And not only me, she makes Vishal make a tune, another tune for that. And being her producer and writer, still she does it. But then, that's the ethics of the trade also.
Right.
As a writer, you have to listen to your director. You have to finally do it. That's why I'm not interested in doing scripts with her, because I can't do 2-3 versions that Vishal will do.
That's could you just recite 2 lines of the lyrics from this movie?
Jis din aakash veda hoga, chehra chand ka saaf hoga. Jis din samay ne aankhein kholi, insaaf, insaaf, insaaf hoga. That's what it is.
Thank you so much, Gulzar Sahab. Thank you so much, Meghna. It was lovely talking to both of you.
Thank you. It was very nice talking to you.
Thank you.